Hi, I'm Oscar van Deventer, and these are the non-transitive gears. They are based on an idea by Alexander Podiakov, who wrote an article about non-transitivity. You know, transitivity means that if 2 is larger than 1, and 3 is larger than 2, then 3 is also larger than 1. A well-known example from non-transitivity is rock, paper, scissor. As we know, rock beats scissor, scissor beats paper, and paper beats rock. And we have other examples, there are cases in elections when you have 3 candidates. If candidate A goes against B, B or against C, or C against A, then also there in elections you can get non-transitivity. But Alexander came up with the idea of applying it to gears. So as you can see already at the inside, this is a geared mechanism. So our challenge is, which of these gears turns the fastest? And I guess you can already think what's happening. So let's turn R, red. And what we see is that the blue one is turning more slowly and the green one is turning faster. So apparently green is faster than red. Okay, then let's turn green. And we see that green is indeed faster than red. But hey, what do we have now? The blue one is turning even faster than the green one. So let's turn green. Blue. So if I turn blue, yes, blue is faster than green. But it's slower than red, which is faster than blue. And of course, going back to red, it's again faster than blue. So red beats blue, green beats red, and blue beats green. So how did I make this non-transitivity? Well, first of all, I used the gears by Alexander Podiakov. You can see there is a gearing ratio of 1 to 2 between green and red, between red and blue, and between blue and green. And in order not to make them block, because you know gears can't rotate in a triangle, I added these little ratchets. I hope you can see them. When I'm turning like this, you can see them. Ratchet. And that's of course the trick how it works, because whichever gear you turn, there's another ratchet that clicks. So this is a very nice mechanism that shows non-transitive gears, but it's not yet a puzzle. So my question to you is, how could you use a mechanism similar to this and turn it into a puzzle? Thank you for watching.